안녕하세요, 김 선생이에요.
Today, I'm going to cover Korean question words. These are quite straightforward, but there are some confusing parts, like when to use 어느 over 무슨 or 어떤. So, if you want to finally master these, you're watching the right video. At the end of this video, I've made a grammar quiz for you, so watch it till the end. Okay, then, let's get started. First things first, how to make WH questions in Korean. The big difference between WH questions in English and in Korean is the location of question words. In English, question words are placed at the beginning of the sentences. For example, who called? What did you buy? When shall we meet? But in Korean, it depends on the grammatical functions of question words. You know that the word order in Korean is subject first, then object, the verb at the end, right? So if a question word is used as a subject, then it should be placed in the location of the subject, meaning at the beginning of the sentence. For example, who called? In Korean would be 누가 전화했어요? Here 누가 who is located at the beginning of the sentence. And what did you buy? In Korean would be 너는 무엇을 샀어? Here 무엇, what is placed in the middle of the sentence, as it is used as an object. When shall we meet in Korean would be
우리 언제 만날까?
when is placed before the verb. For a start, who? It's a pronoun. In Korean, 누구? As it's a pronoun, several particles can be attached to 누구. For example, when the subject case particle 가 is attached, then it's 누가. It's abbreviation of 누구가. Well, we don't use 누구가, but 누가. For example, 누가 왔어요? Who came? When the object particle is attached, then 누구를. For example, 철수는 누구를 좋아해요? Who does 철수 like? 누구를 object, that's why it's placed in the middle. 누가 subject, placed at the beginning of the sentence. When a dative particle is attached, then 누구에게?
이 선물을 누구에게 줄 거예요?
To whom are you gonna give this present? When the possessive particle is attached,
누구의? 이 책은 누구의 것이에요?
Whose book is this? Lastly, 이다 can be attached to the 누구. For example, 이 사람은 누구예요? Who is this person? And also, when we answer the phone, we say hello, 여보세요. Who's this? 누구세요? I've got two tricky questions for you. First one, who is 철수? How do you say that in Korean? There are two ways.
누가 철수예요?
Or
철수가 누구예요?
here 누가 is the subject and here 이다 is attached to the 누구. The answer to this question would be like
이 사람이 철수예요.
this is 철수. It's like who is 철수 among these people? And the answer to this question would be like an explanation of 철수. For example,
철수는 제 학교 친구예요.
Charles is my school friend.
Here, if you don't know why here e is used here 는, then please watch my another video covering 은는 and 이가. My second tricky question is, what's the difference in between these two sentences?
밖에 누가 있어? 밖에 누구 있어?
Here 누가 is who, the interrogative pronoun. So it means, who is out there? The answer to this question would be then,
철수가 밖에 있어.
철수 is out there. And here 누구 is the indefinite pronouns, like anyone. Therefore, it means, is anyone out there? The answer to this question can be then, yes, there is someone, or no, there is no one. Second one, what? In Korean, 무엇? Or the short form, 뭐? It's more commonly used. These are pronouns. So when 무엇 is used as a subject, then subject particle 이가 should be attached. For example,
뭐가 문제예요?
What's the matter? When 무엇 is used as an object, then object particle 을 is used.
무엇을?
The short form 뭐를 or 뭘 or just 뭐. Here you can drop the 를.
무엇을 먹고 싶어?
What do you want to eat? Here the subject 너는 is omitted because I'm talking to you. The subject is too obvious, so we just drop it. And here as well,
너는 뭐를 먹고 싶어?
Here I dropped 를 because it's also obvious that 뭐 is used as an object. 이다 can be attached to 무엇? For example, what's your name? A quick question. How do you say what book are you reading in Korean? What 무엇? 책, book? Are you reading? 읽고 있어요? But this is wrong, because 무엇 is the pronoun. In this case, you should use 무슨 책 읽고 있어요? But this is a determiner. It means a noun should be followed after 무슨. That's why here 무슨 책 읽고 있어요? What book are you reading? And 무슨 is used to ask something that you have no clue. For example,
무슨 생각해?
What are you thinking about? In this case, you have no clue what your friend is thinking about.
무슨 말이야?
What are you talking about? You have no clue what your friend is talking about. The third question word, when? In Korean, 언제? In English, when is just an adverb. But in Korean, it is a pronoun and also an adverb. As it's a pronoun, several particles can be attached. For example, 가, or 부터, or 까지. And also, 이다 can be attached.
시간이 언제가 좋아요?
In English, it means, what time does it suit you? But one-to-one translation would be, when is good for you? When is good for you?
언제까지 숙제를 해야 돼요?
Till when do you have to do your homework?
생일이 언제예요?
When is your birthday? When 언제 is used as an adverb. When do you have time? Here 언제 is an adverb. That's why it is placed before the noun. Next one, where? In Korean, 어디. In English, where is the adverb? But in Korean, 어디 is a pronoun. Therefore, particles can be attached and also 이다. For example, 다음 주에 여행을 가요. I'm going on a trip next week. 어디가 좋을까요? Here, 가, the subject particle is attached to 어디. Then this is the subject. In English, it would be, where would it be good? But in Korean, just where is good? 어디가 좋을까요? Another example with location particle에서 우리 어디에서 만날까요? Where shall we meet? And with 이다 너 지금 어디야? Where are you now? What you need to remember is where in English can stand alone in the sentence. But in Korean, 어디 can't stand alone as it's a pronoun. Therefore, particles or 이다 should be followed. Next one, why. In Korean, 왜. These are adverbs. 오늘 왜 늦게 왔어요? Why did you come late today? Next one, how. In Korean, 어떻게. These are also adverbs. 어떻게 알았어요? How did you know? How did you find out? These are quite simple to use, so I guess you don't need any more examples. And how can be used with adjective or adverbs, right? In this case, you should use 얼마나. For example, how far is it? 얼마나 멀어요? One more example. How often do you go to the gym? And how much? In Korean, 얼마. For example, 이 가방은 얼마예요? How much is this bag? And how many? In Korean, 몇. For example, 사과 몇 개 드릴까요? How many apples do you want to have? Here, 개, the counter for things, is used. If what you're asking is countable, then you should use 몇. For example, how old are you? What you're asking is the age, which is countable. That's why in Korean, 몇 살이에요? Here, 몇 is used. Finally, last one, which. In Korean, 어느. 어느 is a determiner, so it requires a noun. It is used to ask about choice from a selection of options. Selection of options should be very obvious for the speaker and the listener. Let's say I have iced Americano, latte, and cappuccino. Which one do you want to drink? So in this case, the selection of options are very clear. So in Korean, you should say 어느 것을 마실래? Which one do you want to drink? Another good example, where are you from? In Korean, 어느 나라에서 왔어요? 나라, country. In this word, we have 195 countries. The selection of options is very clear for the speaker and the listener. Therefore, 어느 나라. So normally there are two ways to answer to 어느 questions. 어느 것을 마실래? 나는 이것을 마실래. I'm gonna drink this. 이것, this, or 저것, 그것, that can be the answer to 어느 questions. Or proper nouns. For example, 어느 나라에서 왔어요? Where are you from? I'm from Korea. 한국에서 왔어요. The proper noun is used. And 어느 can be used to ask quantity or degree. In this case, 정도 or 만큼 should be followed after 어느. For example, let's say I have a headache, so I went to see a doctor, and then the doctor would ask me, 어느 정도 아파요? It means how painful is it? So to what extent is your pain? What's confusing is 어떤. It's also a determiner, meaning noun should be followed. It's also used to ask the choice from options. But these options are not so limited as 어느. Therefore, we tend to use 어떤 more. But in many cases, 어떤 and 어느 are interchangeable. For example, when you're about to order a coffee, then the worker at the coffee shop would ask you, 어떤 음료를 드릴까요? Or, 어느 음료를 드릴까요? Which beverage do you want to have? They both are correct. But when it comes to the question, where are you from? Then you should use 어느 나라. And 어떤 is also used to ask detailed or specific content. For example, 어떤 일로 오셨어요? What brings you here? You could also say, 무슨 일로 오셨어요? This sentence with 무슨 literally means what brings you here. And with 어떤, it means what's the specific reason that you're here. So when you use 어떤, you're expecting a detailed answer. Lastly, 어떤 is used to ask particular features or characteristics of a thing or a person. For example, 한국은 어떤 나라예요? What is Korea like? 그 남자는 어떤 사람이에요? What is he like? In summary, 무슨, 어느, 어떤 are determiners. And they are question words. But they also have meaning like some or any, referring to someone or something that is unknown or unspecified. But in this video, we're gonna just focus on question words. So 무슨 is used to ask something that you have no clue. There are some cases where 무슨 and 어떤 are possible to use. For example, 무슨 생각해? 어떤 생각해? With 무슨, it means, what are you thinking about? And with 어떤, what exactly are you thinking about? So you expect more detailed, specific answer. And 어떤 is used to ask particular features or characteristics of a thing or a person. 어떤 and 어느 has which meaning? And 어느 is used to ask quantity or degree. 만큼 or 정도 should be followed. And this intersection part drives you crazy, right? 무슨 책을 읽었어? What book did you read? So the answer to this question can be 해리 포터를 읽었어. I read Harry Potter. 어느 책을 읽었어? Which book did you read? The answer to this question can be 나는 이 책을 읽었어. I read this book. 어떤 책을 읽었어? Which book did you read? The answer to this question can be 흥미로운 책을 읽었어. I read an interesting book. Now here comes the grammar quiz. 너는 사람이 좋아? 나는 착하고 가정적인 남자가 좋아. I like the man who's kind and who's also a family man. So here, 어떤 사람이 좋아? Because you're asking the characteristics of this person. Number two, 영화 볼래? 나는 이 영화가 보고 싶어. I wanna watch this movie. The definer is used. Therefore, 어느 영화 볼래? As I mentioned earlier, there are two ways to answer to 어느 questions. First one with 이, 월, 그, 월처. Or proper nouns. 이게 도대체 냄새야? What on earth is this smell? You have no idea what this smell is, therefore, 무슨? How can I get to library? How? 어떻게? 도서관에 어떻게 가요? For a present, what do you want to get? 선물로 무엇을? What? Or you could say, 뭐를? Or just 뭐? Number 6. With whom are you eating the meal? With whom? 누구랑? And who became a president? Who as a subject? Therefore, 누가 대통령이 되었어? Till when do you have a vacation? 언제까지? Till when? 언제까지? Where should I transfer the bus? Where? 어디에서? Place particle is used. When are you gonna meet 철수? When? 언제? 철수랑 언제 만나기로 했어? So here 언제 is the adverb. It stands alone. And here 언제 is a pronoun. That's it for today. If you find my video helpful, please subscribe my channel. If you have any questions, leave me a comment. Thanks for watching. 다음에 또 만나요. 안녕.